Hey, I'm Andy Allidart, and in this edition of History of Rock, we're going to take a look at one of my favorite bands of all time, The Who. Considered by many to be the greatest rock band of all time, The Who formed in London in 1964 as leader guitarist and principal writer Pete Townshend, singer Roger Daltrey, bassist John Entwistle, and drummer Keith Moon joined forces. Throughout an incredible six-decade career, the band has sold over 100 million albums worldwide. Pete Townshend would prove to be one of rock's most dynamic performers, exemplified by his wild, circular windmill strumming technique and the ritualistic smashing of his guitar. Townshend, Daltrey, and Entwistle became friends when very young, while in grammar school. In 1959, Daltrey, then 15 years old, formed the Detours. And by 61, he brought Entwistle and Townshend into the fold. The band played lots of covers, especially instrumental tunes by The Shadows and The Ventures. The band began their professional career by opening for established acts, one being Johnny Kidd and the Pirates, who had a hit with Shakin' All Over. The Pirates' one guitar lineup intrigued Townshend and inspired The Who's musical direction. The Who would later record the definitive version of Shakin' All Over on their million-selling 1970 album, Live at Leeds. When they discovered there was another band called The Detours, they changed their name to The Who. At a gig in April of 1964, Pete Townshend said, "A tiny man dressed all in ginger, with ginger-colored hair, drinking a ginger beer, walked up, pointed at our drummer, and said, 'I'm better than him.' We let him play, and he completely destroyed our drummer's kit. His name was Keith Moon, and he became our drummer immediately thereafter." An early manager renamed the band The High Numbers, and they recorded and released their first single, I'm the Face, back with Zoot Suit. Both songs failed to chart, and the band fired him and changed their name back to The Who. In late 1964, Shel Talmy, the producer of the then chart-topping Kinks, decided to produce the band. Pete had written I Can't Explain as an homage to the Kinks, specifically in order to fire Talmy's interest, and it worked. It was their first single as The Who, and was backed with the traditional blues song Bald Headed Woman, for which Talmy took songwriting credit. By late 64, the band had established themselves as the leaders of the new British youth movement known as the Mods. Townshend was fascinated with noise and musical anarchy. A perfect example is the guitar solo on their second single, Anyway, Anyhow, Anywhere, devised of violent pick slides, flicking of the guitar's toggle switch, and feedback. Released in May of 1965, this is one of the earliest examples of electric guitar feedback on a pop record. The Who hit pay dirt with their third single, My Generation, released on October 29, 1965. The track went to number 2 in the UK. Their first album, The Who Sings My Generation, came out on December 3, 1965. Another Townshend gem on this record is the pop masterpiece, The Kids Are All Right.
The kids are all right.
Substitute was released on March 4th, 1966. The song was meant as a bit of a parody of the Rolling Stones' current hit, 19th Nervous Breakdown, though the song's initial inspiration came from the Smokey Robinson hit, Tracks of My Interior. You think my shoes are made. '66 through '68 brought many more hit records, such as Happy Jack, Pictures of Lily, I Could See for Miles, and Magic Bus. At the Monterey Pop Festival in June of '67, Jimi Hendrix borrowed Pete Townshend's guitar-smashing idea, taking it a step further by burning the guitar as well. At the time, Pete accused Jimmy of stealing his act, but they became good friends soon thereafter. In 1968, Townshend began a spiritual quest and studied the teachings of Indian spiritual master Maribaba. This laid the groundwork for the band's magnum opus, the rock opera Tommy. Prior to the album's release, the first single, Pinball Wizard, hit the charts on March 7, 1969, and was a smash hit. The album would be released later in the spring on May 23, 1969. Tommy was an international sensation, selling 200,000 copies in the U.S. alone in the first 2 weeks. The album would forever define the band as it positioned them in the highest echelon of rock's elite bands. The Who's Live at Leeds, released on May 23, 1970, is revered as the definitive live rock album of all time. For History of Rock, I'm Andy Alidorf.